you ever heard of the Princeton Project? You know, the experiments involving time travel and things called slipgates. The project originally started in 1938 under a different name by the German Wehrmacht's top scientist. The experiments were inspired by excerpts from Egyptian lore found inscribed in hieroglyphs in a temple that depicted a portal to the realm of shadows, or something of that nature. Hitler, who was rumored to be a very superstitious man, took interest in the story. The ancient hieroglyphs stated that if a certain ritual was performed, a portal would open, awakening a great beast, which was rumored to cast a plague upon the earth and shrouded in suffering, save for the people who were responsible for its return, which would be granted the gift of eternal life. Hitler, ever intrigued by the allure of supernatural power, had ordered that the rituals be followed through, using POWs as subjects. The rituals were often violent in nature, and included horrid, grotesque dismemberment and gross disfigurement. Quite often, the rituals were associated with mass blood sacrifices and the ghastly sacrifice of a man resembling the beast. The beast was depicted in inscriptions as a tall, slim creature with long, spindly appendages. Many do seem to believe that the creature is supposed to be the Slender Man, but it is unclear if this is true. The Wehrmacht tried many times to perform the various rituals, which all ultimately ended in failure. Eventually, in 1963, the project was discovered by the UN and swiftly shut down. Many of the personnel who were involved in the project seemed to vanish, with little more than the whispers that they were potentially executed for their involvement. The project lay dormant for years until 1984, which was brought to the attention of the American government, who had the intention to create slipgates, or time travel devices. A year later, the project was picked up by the CIA, FBI, and Secret Service. For years, the project remained shrouded in secrets, until the progress of the experiment was made public in 1992. The project had continued onward without the use of human sacrifice or any of the brutal rituals which were used by the project's founders. However, instead of summoning a supernatural being, the experimentation resulted in many scientific strides in the study of time travel theory, black holes, wormholes. The project continues today, still run by the agencies that have revived it. The information that the project is still considered declassified, and basic details are allowed to be released to the public. However, for safety reasons, most of this information is still kept behind closed doors and under government protection. This is most likely for the better. Yet it leaves one to wonder what strides the project possibly could be making. The government, however, does accept donations for the funding of the experiment, which is currently dubbed the Princeton Project. There are many rumors going around about the project. Some are quite popular, and I think are quite interesting, but here are two that I find most relevant. Sometime between 1992 and 2003, the U.S. government came into the possession of a miniaturized black hole of sorts. It was supposedly around 0.000001% the size and density of an actual black hole, and was kept in stasis underground. It was rumored that it was disposed of due to the upkeep of the stasis field being too costly. The theory states that it was terminated by using thermite to incinerate the stasis facility, causing the black hole to collapse, but was unable to, due to not being big enough to crush the facility, and crush itself into oblivion and disappeared. The time travel devices currently exist and are banned from use. The theory also states that there are specific laws that the world governments have laid out for time travel. It is also rumored that the device has been used to alter events in history such as the Crusades, many biblical-related pieces of history, 9/11, the Holocaust, Munich, and many more. I find most of these ideas to be far-fetched, but not entirely impossible. After all, stranger things are out there, so who is to say that any of this isn't true? Well, anyway, sorry to have wasted your time with this. I hope it was worth the weed. I have doubts, however. Thank you all for your kindness and time. And again, I'm sorry for the boredom.